Welcome to our Advent Virtual Liturgy. We would normally be at St. Peter's Basilica celebrating together. Although we are physically apart, we are spiritually together. The spirit of Catholic Central surrounds us and enriches our school. In a very special way, we welcome our feeder schools who are also joining us virtually. Welcome students and staff from Blessed Sacrament, Holy Rosary, St. Bernadette, St. Jude, St. Martin, St. Mary Choir, St. Michael, and St. Sebastian. We gather today to celebrate Advent. Advent, the time of waiting. We wait as a people in peaceful darkness, longing for, searching for, the light who is Christ. We wait in hope. We wait in faith. We wait in joy. We wait in peace. Please listen to beautiful music from our Camerata and grade 12 string students led by Ms. Martinelli.
Let us begin our time together in prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, Advent calls us to reflect as we consciously and quietly wait on the promised gift of Jesus. It is a time of preparation, a time of peace. We wait in darkness, opening our hearts to you, God, as we journey towards celebrating the birth of your Son. Help us to keep our focus on Jesus, to not be distracted by the hurrying and scurrying the season often brings. We have journeyed through the hope represented in the first purple candle, the faith of the second purple candle, the joy of the pink candle, and the peace symbolized in the final purple candle. We thank you for this time of reflection. We thank you for the incredible gift of your Son. Amen.
Our reading from the book of Prophet Isaiah. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us, authority rests upon his shoulder. And he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall rule continually, and there shall be endless peace from the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice, and will reign in truth from the time onward and forevermore. The seal of the Lord of Hosts will do this. The word of the Lord. Amen.
The response is, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Response? The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Response. One thing I asked of the Lord, that will I seek after, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. Response. I believe that I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord, be strong. And let your heart take courage. Wait for the Lord. Response.
This is a reading from the Gospel according to St. Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Before she said yes to God's request to be the mother of Jesus and see her life go in a different direction than maybe she had planned, Mary had to reflect and think about it. I think that's a model for us, because Christmas is always a time for you and me to think about some things that are very important in our faith and in our life, and to think about these things in the context of maybe looking at some changes. Can I suggest three? What about this Christmas of thinking of our image of God? And moving away from seeing God as always distant, always way out there, watching us, but only to catch us in a mistake and judging us, making us feel guilty about ourselves. What if we change to seeing God wanting a personal relationship with each of us? To see a God who accompanies us every day of our life through his son Jesus, whose love is unconditional, who wants to forgive us, and who desperately wants us not to be afraid of him. This, however it is for each of us, will come through regular prayer and taking time to reflect. Secondly, what about our attitude to life? Seeing life every day as a person of faith. Are we willing to go beyond just religious practices alone and make an intention about being a follower of Jesus? Seeing life, the life that I have been given, as a gift and a journey during which we allow ourselves to be more and more possessed and loved by God. A journey where we become aware of the movement of God's Spirit in our life, an awareness of those who are constantly in need, and an ability to see more and more of life with the compassionate eyes of Jesus. And thirdly, what about the choices we make? Upon what exactly are my day-to-day choices based? Advent and Christmas, but Advent particularly right now, is a precious gift of time to straighten out what is not yet right. to overcome any particular struggles that maybe leave us in some form of darkness. It's an opportunity to heal what we've broken, to forgive, to be more generous, to bring Jesus back into our lives, no matter how shattered or wonderful they are. We know that he comes to find us in the broken places where we know we can't make it on our own. And it's a well-founded fact. It is only admitting our need for God that our spirits become big enough to be filled with God's love and compassion. And so, wherever you and I find ourselves this Christmas, God will definitely find us. He will approach us exactly as we are, broken or whole, in great joy or experiencing sadness, well put together or in need of repair. Jesus is never aloof or distant from our world. He always exists in the midst of it, where people are carrying out the task that they have been given. And you and I will find him as long as we're willing to search for him. I hope you and your families have a safe, hope-filled, and Merry Christmas. And I will be praying for our Catholic Central community at Mass on Christmas Eve. Merry Christmas.
Prayers of the Faithful. Beza saatsia nizahal munista janda oni fatna egzaber amla mehrezin qsana sinkor dello nitsemi na baamlahna nitsemi. For those who are sick or in distress, we pray that they will be healed by God's loving grace. We pray to the Lord.
Oramos por los pobres para que ellos también disfruten de una Navidad agradable. Oramos para que los menos afortunados sean ayudados por aquellos de nosotros que somos más afortunados. Roguemos al Señor.
We pray for the poor that they may also have an enjoyable Christmas. We pray that the less fortunate are helped by those of us who are more fortunate. We pray to the Lord.
Tunaombea wale wanaomboleza, wapendwa wao, ili Mungu awasaidie wapate amani na furaha. Tunaomba kwa Bwana, amen.
We pray for those who are mourning love, one, that God will help them to find the peace and joy. We pray for the Lord, amen.
Preghiamo per i senza tetto e per quelli che sono soli, che possono trovare un rifugio sicuro e felicità durante queste feste.
We pray for the homeless and those who are lonely, that they may find shelter and happiness during these days. These holidays, we pray to the Lord.
من أجل السنة في مجتمعنا وفي بلدنا وفي عالمنا أن في يوم من الأيام لن يكون هناك عنصري ولا كره ولا خوف نصلي للرب.
For peace in our community, in our country, in our world, that one day there will be no racism, no hate, no fear. We pray to the Lord.
Idalangin lahat ang mga mag-aaral at tahuan ng St. Sebastian, St. Michael, St. Mary Choir, St. Martin, St. Jude, St. Bernadette, Holy Rosary, mapalad ng mga sakramento at lahat ng Catholic Central, magkakaroon ng ligtas at mapagpalang Pasko, nananalangin tayo sa Panginoon. We pray that all students and staff of St. Sebastian, St. Michael, St. Mary Choir, St. Martin, St. Jude, St. Bernadette, Holy Rosary, bless the sacrament and our Catholic Central. Have a safe, blessed Christmas. We pray to the Lord.
Good morning, Crusaders. Waiting is essential to our spiritual life. But waiting as a disciple of Jesus is not an empty waiting. It is a waiting with a promise in our hearts that makes us already present what we are waiting for. We wait during Advent for the birth of Jesus. Waiting for God is an active, alert, yes, joyful waiting. As we wait, we remember him from whom we are waiting. And as we remember him, we create a community ready to welcome him when he comes. Christmas is the powerful sign and grace-filled opportunity of reconciliation between heaven and earth, among family members, friends, and colleagues, not only in our homes and our churches, but throughout our communities and the world. The story of salvation is how God can change the human heart, how the Lord came down from heaven to reconcile the world to himself. Pope Francis reminds us that faith is born of an encounter with the living God who calls us and reveals his love, a love which precedes us and upon which we can learn for security and for building our lives. Transformed by his love, we gain fresh vision, new eyes to see. We realize it contains a great promise of fulfillment and that a vision of the future opens up before us. Jesus invites us, people of love, generosity and bringers of joy, and makers of peace. Good morning, Crusaders. It brings me great joy to welcome you to our Advent Liturgy. I know today is not like gathering at St. Peter's as a faith-filled community where we all belong. Nonetheless, we are a Crusader family, and gathering virtually is how we adapt to these circumstances. We are very blessed to have our chaplaincy leader, Mrs. Bell, at the helm, and who has put this exquisite Advent Liturgy together with the help of our staff and our amazing students. To that end, on behalf of our amazing staff and caring and compassionate home, we would like to wish you all a blessed Christmas and a peaceful New Year. Remember to take time for yourself, family, and prayer. May God bless all of you. Crusaders, woo!
Advent, the time of waiting for Christ. He came so long ago, this child of Christmas night. And ever since that night, this same Jesus stands at our doors, quietly asking to be welcomed into our homes and into our hearts. Ever since that night when the angels sang, he has given up all that he has, given the very gift of himself to us. As Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Those who follow me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." At Christmas, we will celebrate the birth of our Lord. The light will come amongst us. We end our liturgy with Feliz Navidad in honor of Mr. Kaja, our former ESL teacher, who for many, many years led us in this classic song to end our Advent Mass. I wish you and yours a very Merry Christmas. God's peace to you.
Thank you. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom of my heart.
Merry Christmas!
Feliz Navidad!